I first met the Shred Kelly folk while bartending at the Royal on Baker in Nelson. I guess maybe probably 10 years ago now.
I joined the band about 20 months ago, 21 months ago. For me being like the newest member, a lot has changed even since I started. I'm joining things, it seems, at a bit of a turning point for the band. Like it feels like a new chapter, and it feels like all the people in the band are kind of entering a different part of their lives.
The way I came to play with Shred Kelly is a bit of a long story, so I'll shorten it up a bit. But I was bartending at the Royal on Baker, and it was one of the venues where Shred Kelly had first played when they left Fernie, and they developed a really big fan base here in Nelson in the early days, and we developed a friendship, and then an opportunity came up where their current guitar player at that time needed a bit of time off. So I hopped on for a tour that went across the country, and it was kind of only supposed to be a few weeks, and then life happens and things happened, and eventually, well, it's been 6.5 years now.
Actually, I don't know if we would be a band if it wasn't for this town. It was about 2000 and I want to say 7 or 8 that I bought my first banjo. And the whole reason I bought a banjo was because of this band called Elliott Brood. One summer we heard that they were playing here at the Hume Hotel. So myself and a bunch of friends, I think 8 of us, made a pilgrimage to Nelson to go see them. We ended up actually getting to hang out with this band that were heroes of ours. I remember telling these guys that I really, really wanted to, start a band. This was a major dream of mine. And they said, well, yeah, just do it. Why don't you just do it? And I was like, yeah, I should just do it.
The one thing I always loved about Shred is they would go to the ski hill and promote the show ahead of time, so they'd come earlier in the day and like handbill and flyer up at Whitewater to get people to come, and it worked. I mean, they would get a lineup down the street.
Maybe today, my vessel.
there ever been a disappointing Shred Kelly show? Like, I can't imagine there has been. I've never seen one, right? Like, every show they bring absolutely 100%, and the crowd feeds off of it. And then word travels, and it's word of mouth. And, yeah, I have never doubted that we would be here after 10 years.